Orders update. Let's have a look at the stock. Today it's gapping up because over the weekend we heard the news that they are about to get added to Nasdaq 100. So beginning of next Monday, basically 20th of December, it will be included in Nasdaq 100. So what to watch from here? So I want to give two examples of not Nasdaq but S&P 500 inclusions. So we're going to take a look at the Tesla, what happened to Tesla and when it added, and from the moment it added, what it did, and also one successful, one failed, because I just want to give you guys a perspective, like if these ETFs are going to buy, well, it doesn't mean that's a green light. If that gets included, it will pretty much succeed from there, or it will fail from there. So it doesn't mean anything. It doesn't bring any it doesn't change the fundamentals of the business, but there will be a buying. Okay, so this is the Tesla, right? So let's have a look at Tesla. Go 1 years back, 2 years back actually, and I made a video about this one as well back when they were included in S&P 500. So Tesla was trading at around 406. And then we got the news that they are going to get added to S&P 500. It was end of November, and they said that it will be included in December 21st, something like that. So by that time, Tesla was trading already at 650. And then as soon as Tesla got added, from 650, it went up all the way till 882 in about like very short period of time. And the good thing is about SPY ETF, I can't see what S&P 500 is doing, but SPY ETF, which tracks S&P 500, shows me exactly how many shares they own at what price. So by looking at this, you can see, hey, they bought a Tesla, and they own their average price for Tesla, $772, and they paid for 8.8 million shares. That's their average cost, all right? So they accumulated at those prices. Also, another one is S&P 500 added to, well, there's another example which didn't do as well because S&P 500 bought it at much higher prices, and stock right now is trading at $47 right now, so which is Penn National. Penn National at a time was trading at around 110 or maybe even 130 all-time highs, and after S&P 500 inclusion, it did go up to 142. So, and then from 142, well, the rest is history. So, and Penn National, so I looked it up already on SPY, they own about 1.6 million shares at 114 average price, and look where it is. So it can go either way, but there will be definitely buying volume next week. As soon as they get it, these ETFs will buy it. So for Lucid, well, we know that all-time highs, and this is double top, however you want to look at, is 57.68. Valuation of the Lucid is pretty high already. So above 40 bucks, well, you want to watch 45 resistance and then 50 resistance below. So at the moment, I'm looking at the 50-day simple moving average, this yellow line, let me bring up fully, as a support. All right, so if after the inclusion, so if you are bearish, you don't want to bet to the downside until this stock actually gets included in Nasdaq, and let that buying, pretty much whoever wants to buy, they buy it, and then afterwards you're gonna see natural move, and if that slips below $36 pretty much, then you can say, hey, okay, it can come down to these lows right here, 33, and then maybe it's a breakout level over if it wants to test that 28. But at the time, well, it could fake you out many times this week because there are a lot of shorts still in it. Well, at the moment, well, stock is up 2%, maybe they're not panicking because it couldn't get back above 40. But if it stayed above 40, I mean, short sellers alone could have taken this stock at least to 45. But just watching, I'm personally watching it from sidelines because momentum for the stock lately for the past 10 trading sessions has been to the downside. And that news, well, I would just be cautious to trade it either way. Ideally, I would just stay on a sidelines until they get included in NASDAQ 100. And then from there, I would see where the stock is going to pick the momentum. Is it going to pick momentum to the upside, or will keep selling? Because at the moment, well, it's at the support. So let's see what it does. Thanks for watching. I'm getting a lot of alerts to trade. So there's looks like GME dropping, Upwork. So, all right. See you guys in the next one. Peace.